Welcome back to the final video in our Getting Started tutorial series. From watching our previous videos, you now have a solid understanding of how to create adaptive and dynamic audio for your games using FMOD Studio. The final step is getting your audio from FMOD Studio into your game engine. Because games are usually separated into levels or areas, game engines dynamically load in and out groups of sounds as necessary. Let's say you have a platforming game with multiple levels, and each level has its own habitat. For example, a forest, and then a snowy region. You would put all of the sounds required specifically for the forest habitat in one group, all the sounds specifically for the snow habitat in another, and finally all of the sounds that are shared by both in a third group. The game engine would then load the shared group and the forest group for the forest habitat, then on changing to the snow habitat would unload the forest sounds and load the snow sounds. This means you only have the sounds you need loaded at any point. In FMOD Studio, we can easily group sounds into banks, which are then exported from FMOD Studio into your game project's content folder. Then, using the functions provided in FMOD for Unity, FMOD for Unreal, or FMOD Engine, you can choose when to load each bank as needed. You can think of banks like a folder on your hard drive, but for FMOD events instead of just sound files. By assigning FMOD events to banks, you assign every sound that's been added to that event to the bank. This means all you have to do is create events and assign them to banks as needed, and FMOD Studio will handle the organization of your sound files for the game engine. To assign an event to a bank in FMOD Studio, all you need to do is right-click the event, select Assign to Bank, then select your desired bank. FMOD Studio creates a master bank for use by default. This master bank contains data related to your project, such as mixer and routing information, and therefore needs to be loaded at all times. To avoid loading your sounds at all times as well, it's best practice to create individual banks as required. You can create a new bank by either selecting New Bank from the same menu, or by selecting the Banks tab, right-clicking and selecting New Bank. Now that we have our banks set up, we need to make them into a format that the game engine can read. We call this process building. When you want to build in FMOD Studio, you can create multiple platforms to build to, each with their own compression settings. Each different platform will get built into its own folder inside the master build folder location. To put it simply, in FMOD Studio, you add the different platforms required for your project and adjust their settings. You can then load your sounds into events and then assign those events to different banks. Finally, you set the build path in FMOD Studio and then build the banks, either for a specific platform or for every platform added. To get our final step started, let's set our build path by navigating to the Edit menu and selecting Preferences to open the FMOD Studio Preferences dialog. From here, select the Build tab to access our build settings. To set our build path, you just need to assign the location under the first option, Built Banks Output Directory. By default, FMOD Studio will build all banks to a folder within its own projects called Built. If you point your game engine to these folders or your FMOD project is inside your game's content folder, assuming you have the correct settings in your game engine, then this could work. However, if you're storing your FMOD project in a separate location, you'll need to set up a specific folder inside your game's content folder. For Unity users, this would be somewhere inside the Assets folder of your game. For Unreal users, it would be inside the Content folder. Moving further down in the Build tab, you'll find the Project Platforms area. Here, you can set up each platform that you'll be building for. By default, FMOD Studio has added the desktop platform. For now, let's create a mobile platform by right-clicking here, selecting Add Platform, and selecting Mobile. You may notice FMOD Studio has automatically changed some settings for us, such as speaker mode, the default encoding format, and sample rate. You can freely adjust these as required per platform to optimize your specific use case. It's important to remember that these settings are only the project's default settings. You can override them per platform, per asset, or per folder in the Assets tab. To do this, first navigate to the Assets tab, then check which platform you're currently previewing under the Platform section here. Now, you can add a custom platform encoding setting by selecting any folder or asset and left-clicking in its properties here. You can then switch between each created platform via the drop-down menu at any point to access the different compression settings. Remember, this process is only required if you want individual control over your compression settings. If no custom platform encoding settings are added, FMOD Studio will always default to the platform's default settings we created. Finally, to generate the banks, FMOD Studio will need to execute the build process. To do this, you can navigate to File and then either build the currently selected platform, or Build All Platforms to build each platform that you've created. Alternatively, you can press F7 to build the current platform, or Shift plus F7 to build all. Now that our banks are built, let's take a quick look at getting sounds to play inside Unity and Unreal. For a full walkthrough on getting FMOD Studio integrated into either Unity or Unreal, you can see our dedicated videos, which we've linked in the description. In Unity, to import the F1 integration, navigate to Assets, Import Package, and then select Custom Package. Select the FMOD for Unity package, then Import. Once the import is complete, you can access the FMOD project settings via the FMOD menu here. Select Edit Settings, then open the Bank Import dropdown. From here, you have three options. If you have the FMOD project located inside your Assets folder, select FMOD Studio Project. If you only have one platform or haven't added any extra platforms, select Single Platform Build. If you've added multiple platforms, like we have here, select Multiple Platform Build. As we have multiple platforms in our FMOD project, we'll select Multiple Platform Build. Now all we need is a folder in our Unity project for FMOD to build to. So right-click in the Assets folder in Unity, select Create and Folder. We can name this folder SFX Banks. Now, if you right-click this new folder and select Show in Explorer or Show in Finder on Mac, Unity will open the location of this folder. Copy this location, navigate back to FMOD Studio and open the Build tab under Preferences. Now you can just paste this location in the Build Location text box. Finally, make sure to build by selecting File and then Build All Platforms. Now, returning to Unity and the FMOD Settings tab, you can set the same folder location here as well. This will ensure that Unity can see the folders that we've just created. Then, if you return to the FMOD menu in Unity and select Event Browser, you'll open the Browser panel. From here, you can select and preview events, as well as adjust parameters while previewing. For Unreal, to install the FMOD for Unreal plugin, you need to navigate to your Unreal Project's parent folder. The easiest way to do this is to right-click the content folder and select Show in Explorer or Finder on Mac. Then navigate up one level so that you can see the Unreal Project file. In this folder, navigate to the Plugins folder, or Create it if you can't see it, and place the FMOD Studio and FMOD Niagara folders found in the FMOD for Unreal download here. You should now have a folder structure that looks something like this. Now to integrate our FMOD Studio project, first make sure you have your desired FMOD Studio project open, then return to Unreal Engine, navigate to Help, and select Validate FMOD. This should automatically set the correct build path in FMOD Studio and prompt you to resave the project. Return to FMOD Studio, confirm the new build path location, and save the project. When you return to Unreal Engine, you can see all our events inside the Events folder. You can preview any of these events by double-clicking the asset to open it and clicking the play button. And with that, we're done. We've covered all the basics of FMOD Studio, from the foundations such as events, sheets, instruments, and parameters. Then we covered how to control our audio dynamically using these features. And finally, how to build your dynamic audio ready for the game engine to play. Don't forget, you can follow us on social media at FMOD Studio on Twitter, Facebook, and LinkedIn. You can also use the FMOD Studio tag to show us what you come up with. Keep an eye on our channel for more tips, features, and tricks on FMOD Studio. And thank you so much for watching. We really hope you enjoyed our FMOD Studio Getting Started series and look forward to seeing you in the next video.